Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Friday of the second week of Advent. Our Mass Presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. Behold, the Lord will come descending with splendor to visit His people with peace, and He will bestow on them eternal life.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Grant that your people, we pray, Almighty God, may be ever watchful for the coming of your only begotten Son, that as the author of our salvation himself has taught us, we may hasten alert with lighted lamps to meet him when he comes, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, your Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. I, the Lord your God, teach you what is for your good and lead you on the way you should go. If you would hearken to my commandments, your prosperity would be like a river and your vindication like the waves of the sea. Your descendants would be like the sand, and those born of your stock like its grains, their name never cut off or blotted out from my presence. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Those who follow you, Lord, will have the light of life.
Those who follow you, Lord, will have the light of life.
Blessed the man who follows not the counsel of the wicked, nor walks in the way of sinners, nor sits in the company of the insolent, but delights in the law of the Lord and meditates on his law day and night.
Those who follow you, Lord, will have the light of life.
He is like a tree planted near running water that yields its fruit in due season and whose leaves never fade. Whatever he does prospers.
Those who follow you, Lord, will have the light of life.
Not so the wicked, not so. They are like chaff which the wind drives away. For the Lord watches over the way of the just, but the way of the wicked vanishes.
Those who follow you, Lord, will have the light of life.
Alleluia, alleluia. The Lord will come, go out to meet him. He is the Prince of Peace. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to the crowds, to what shall I compare this generation? It is like children who sit in marketplaces and call to one another. We played the flute for you, but you did not dance. We sang a dirge, but you did not mourn. For John came neither eating nor drinking, and they said, he is possessed by a demon. The Son of Man came eating and drinking, and they said, look, he is a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners. But wisdom is vindicated by her works. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, as we enter the final, no, the final Mass before we begin the Simbang Gabi Masses tomorrow, I'd like to invite you to begin to reflect on the theme that I would try to develop during the Simbang Gabi Masses. No? But first, I just want to point out the very beginning of the Gospel, what the Lord points out. No? I would reflect on this as what I would call the religion of convenience. No? So that's the first point that we'll reflect on. And then the second is, again, I'd like to refer to the witness of John the Baptist, no, as the authentic witness. And then finally, just to reflect, no, in preparation for the Simbang Gabi Masses. No? First, about the religion of convenience. Here the Lord says, no, you know, so we played you a dirge, but we played you a song, but you did not dance. We played you a dirge, but you did not mourn. No? And here the Lord criticizes people who use religion according to their own according to their convenience, no? In a sense, no, it is really manipulating religion, no, for their own ends, no? And we see this a lot, no? This is one of the great criticisms of the Lord, no, of the religious authorities. Again, going back, no, to what we've been reflecting on the last few days, no, for 500 years, no prophet, no one calling them to repentance, and therefore, really the you might say the institutionalization of the wrong practices, no, and really using religion according to their own convenience, not only convenience but for their own ends, no. So that first point to reflect on, and remember what we mentioned a few times in the past, no. What we were told in the seminar, you know, apparently it is one of the ideas of Ignatius, no, wherein he says that do you seek the God of consolation or do you seek consolation? No, trying to recall who said that, but that was told to us by our novice master. No, so again here, no, it is that religion for one's convenience. No, you seek consolation, you seek to feel good, no, and to feel holy. But you do not seek God, no. Ultimately, it is God that we must seek, no. So that first point to reflect on, no. And then the second point is the authentic witness of John the Baptist, no. And here I think, as I mentioned yesterday, it's very important for us to once more reflect and ask ourselves, no, how can we witness as a prophetic voice in our time? I think each one of us, no, we can ask for the grace, and we most certainly, I think, have the duty to become a prophetic voice within our sphere of influence, no? Not to be self-righteous, no? But to be someone who would constantly discern and try to help people discover the path to God, no? I think ultimately that is the role of the prophetic voice. And I think that is the role of an authentic Christian witness with the way we live our life, no? Again, John the Baptist was very authentic, not just by his preaching, but by his lifestyle, by the way he lived his life, no? A certain integrity, no, in the way he lived his life. And again, we are invited to do this, no? We're invited to witness to become prophetic in our own lives, no? To become a prophetic voice, no? That will inspire people to go back to God, that will inspire conversion, that will inspire repentance, no? So maybe that second point to reflect on, no, how can we be like John the Baptist in our day and age and within our sphere of influence? And then the third and final point for our reflection is, as I said, this Simbang Gabi, I will try to develop the theme of witness. No, and I think now more than ever, we need to give authentic witness. No, not to be show-offs, no, but hopefully with our authentic witness, to bring people closer to God, to bring people to the path that leads to God, no? I think that in the end is the witness that is needed, no? Our credibility and authenticity will be, in a sense, proven by how much we are able to lead people back to the path towards God, no? And let us pray, no, as we begin the Simbang Gabi Masses tomorrow, let us pray that may be a grace that we will pray for and that we will be given by the Lord during this coming Christmas season and in the coming New Year. Siguro maganda na pagnilayan natin to ngayon na sa bispiras, no, ng pagsisimula natin ng mga misa ng Simbang Gabi. Siguro maganda na atin din pagnilayan, ano, paano ba tayo magiging isang otentikong mga saksi, no, sa ating pananampalataya. Kagaya sinabi ng Panginoon sa Ebanghelyo ngayong araw, di ba, pinipintasan niya yung mga tao na gumagamit sa relihiyon para sa sarili lamang nilang kagustuhan, ano, na sabi nga sa amin noon sa seminaryo, hinahanap mo ba ang konsolasyon, yung pakiramdam mo maging ano, mabuti para kang spiritually high, o dapat ang hanapin mo ang Diyos ng konsolasyon, hindi lamang ang konsolasyon, no? Ito yung bahagi ng sinasabi ng Panginoon, kasi pinipintasan niya yung mga tao na ginagamit ang relihiyon para sa sarili lamang nilang ano, no, mga hangarin. Sabi nga niya, tumugtog kami, hindi kayo nagsayaw. Tumugtog kami ng masaya, hindi kayo nagsayaw. Tumugtog kami ng malungkot, hindi kayo nagluksa, no? Na parang hindi sila sumusunod, no, sa katotohanan at sa otentikong pagsaksi, no, kundi ginagamit lamang nilang relihiyon ayon sa kanilang sariling ano mga hangarin ano. Tapos yung pangalawang punto na magandang pagnilayan din ay ang saksi ni San Juan Bautista no. Lalo-lalo na papasok na tayo ng simbang gabi bukas. Yan yung isa sa mga masasabi natin main themes na pagninilayan ko sa mga darating na araw no. Papaano ba tayo pwedeng maging mga saksi, maging witness no sa ating pananampalataya kagaya ni San Juan Bautista na napaka-authentico at napaka-lakas ng kredibilidad ano ng kanyang pagiging propeta, pagiging saksi. Papaano natin 'yun magagawa sa sarili nating buhay? At isang pamumuhay na mag-aakit sa tao no na magbalik-loob sa Diyos no dahil sa ating simple at yung masasabi natin otentiko at may kredibilidad na pagsasabuhay ng ating bukasyong Kristiyano no. At yung pangatlong huling punto nga sabi ko nga na ang pagninilayan natin ngayong simbang gabi ay ang pagiging saksi no. So siguro maganda nga na hilingin natin na mabigyan tayo ng biyaya na maging otentiko tayong mga saksi sa Panginoon. At hilingin din natin no, na tayo ay maging ano magkaroon tayo ng kredibilidad no at maging otentiko ang ating pamumuhay bilang mga Kristiyano. Hindi lamang ngayong Pasko kundi sa lahat ng panahon ano sa darating na bagong taon no. So hilingin natin 'to ngayon at hilingin natin na sa simula ng ating simbang gabi bukas ay sana ay talagang pag-isipan natin ano ba ang biyayang nais nating hingin sa ating nobina ng simbang gabi bilang paghahanda sa Pasko at sa darating na bagong taon. In faith, we now make our petition to the Father whose concern is that all people accept His invitation to the banquet of eternal life in heaven.
That the Church on earth may continue to grow and draw more people to the feast of the kingdom, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the rich and the poor alike may not make excuses to evade the call of the kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may respond to the call for repentance with sincerity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. And let us continue to pray for the Holy Father, for his good health, for all his intentions. And especially let us pray together with Him for peace in our world. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be made acceptable to God, Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Be pleased, O Lord, with our humble prayers and offerings, and since we have no merits to plead our cause, come we pray to our rescue with the protection of your mercy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For He assumed at His first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfill the design you formed long ago and opened for us the way to eternal salvation. That when He comes again in glory and majesty and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you." Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us offer our Advent prayer.
God, our Father, we thank you for sending us your beloved Son, Jesus Christ. He is our Emmanuel, God with us, the source of our hope that everything we do and experience with and for you has meaning and will bear fruit here and in eternity. He is our Prince of Peace that gives us the courage that we shall overcome all the trials and tribulations of this world. He is the joy the angels announced when he first came in the manger, where heaven and earth met, your deep gladness to send your Son and our hunger for the Savior. On that holy night of his birth, once in our world, a stable had something in it that was bigger than our whole world, your perfect love for us, Jesus Christ, your beloved Son. May he come quickly into our hearts and life this season and not delay. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
And let us pray. Replenished by the food of spiritual nourishment, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that through our partaking in this mystery, you may teach us to judge wisely the things of earth and hold firm to the things of heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Maraming pong salamat. Have a good weekend ahead. And again, tomorrow we begin our Simbang Gabi. And again, please join us for Proyecto Pilipino and then also Journeys of Hope this weekend, the second part of our conversation with L.A. Tenorio. So maraming pong salamat and let's have a prayerful Simbang Gabi Novena in the coming days. Thank you po. This Christmas, let us bring the love of Christ to many Filipino families
by sharing whatever we can to alay kapwa.
Ano man ang kaya, biyaya sa iba. Ito ang ating alay kapwa.
Sa lahat ng ating mga kapatid, maligayang Pasko po. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas and Happy New Year to all.
Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.